Hi, I'm Melanie Nakagawa, Chief Sustainability Officer at Microsoft, and welcome to Let's Talk Sustainability. Today, we're tackling one of the most complex aspects companies face in progress towards sustainability goals, and that's how to track, measure, and reduce their Scope 3 emissions across their value chain. Joining me today here is Liz Comley, Sustainability Group Manager from our Services Procurement Organization, and Haley Alesi, Senior Sustainability Manager, also from Services Procurement, and Laila Moretti, Senior Program Manager from our Microsoft Cloud for Sustainability Engineering team in Atlanta. They are here today to share their experiences working directly with our suppliers on their carbon disclosure and reduction strategies, and how these experiences have helped inform Microsoft for Sustainability. So welcome, everybody. Liz, I'd love to start with you. According to research done by the Carbon Trust, upward of 90% of most enterprise companies' emissions footprint can result from emissions that occur through their business activities in their value chain. Microsoft has been committed to becoming carbon negative by 2030, and we know that our value chain partners are integral to achieving this. So how are you able to get our value chain partners and suppliers to engage and commit to these targets?
That's a great question. Like a lot of initiatives at Microsoft, we took a crawl, walk, run approach. Our group works with services-based suppliers across the company. So if you think about things like marketing, consulting, and software, those are the types of suppliers my team is working with. And then we do have peer groups at Microsoft who are handling engagement with our manufacturing and data center suppliers. After Microsoft announced its carbon negative commitment in 2020, we were able to add language to our supplier code of conduct. And this really provided an opening to start engaging with our suppliers directly on their carbon impact. Specifically, we ask that they start reporting carbon emissions data to us on an annual basis, and then the more challenging part, working with us to reduce their own emissions by 55% by 2030.
Gaining that sort of visibility into our value chain could not have been an easy task for the company the size of Microsoft. We have hundreds of subsidiaries and suppliers all over the world. Haley, could you share a bit more about your experience working directly with this vast array of suppliers?
Absolutely. The first 2 years of our program, we spent educating our suppliers on carbon accounting, as this was a new concept for so many companies we were engaging with. To help get our suppliers familiar with carbon accounting, we spent a lot of time developing educational and learning resources, and also hosted live webinars to prepare them to disclose their emissions data. But now that our suppliers are more familiar with carbon accounting and disclosure, we're pivoting our focus to driving emission reduction progress. And to do that, and to drive this progress, our collected supplier emissions data is key to informing what reduction levers we'll have to pull.
That must have been quite an investment to build the capacity of our suppliers. So Liz, what happened when you first started getting all this data back in?
Well, as we started reviewing the data, we realized several challenges, the most significant of which was that the data suppliers were disclosing wasn't providing the level of granularity that we needed to inform decision-making around actual emission reduction opportunities. So to address this challenge, we started asking suppliers to disclose more detailed information. For example, we knew purchased goods and services was a key source of emissions. So we asked our suppliers to tell us what the biggest things were that they were buying. And from this more detailed questioning, we were able to uncover that our suppliers were primarily purchasing things like laptops and other office supplies. This additional insight resulted in my team brainstorming specific ways we could help suppliers reduce emissions from these items.
It sounds like getting more granular data around supply chain emissions means you more easily identify opportunities to reduce emissions and help us reach our carbon reduction targets.
Exactly.
So earlier I spoke with Erica Basham, our Director of Sustainability Product Strategy at Microsoft. And in that first video series, we talked about the data challenges Microsoft experienced measuring and tracking our own internal impact. Do you see similar challenges in working with our suppliers?
We definitely did. Because of the early level of awareness and also the complexity around carbon accounting, many of our suppliers didn't know what or how to calculate their emissions. As a result, the maturity of our collected supplier sustainability data was low. So we ended up investing a lot of time working with that initial data that we did receive and then using it to run analysis and reporting against it. In addition to the volume of inconsistent and incompatible data we had coming in, we also had the need for a more simplified approach and an emissions disclosure tool that allowed for customization.
I can appreciate how time-consuming this must have been for all of your teams and our suppliers. So have you been able to reduce any friction points with process improvements or technology?
Yes. So we had the opportunity to partner with the sustainability team and then the Cloud for Sustainability product engineering team to act as customer zero and share our experience and expertise, share insights and feedback from our suppliers, and then also share the gaps we've identified from the existing solutions available. And then with that feedback and our feedback, the tooling, along with the tooling and technical expertise from the Cloud for Sustainability team, we worked together to co-define and write feature specifications for a new emissions reporting capability.
Laila, I know the Microsoft Cloud for Sustainability team was already thinking about solutions to help our customers gain visibility into their value chain for Scope 3 carbon, plus other environmental factors like water and waste management metrics. Has this partnership with these team members informed the product roadmap going forward?
Yeah, that's right. We had been in the early stages of developing a supplier solution. Including Microsoft as customer zero into our product planning allowed us to gain additional perspectives, validate assumptions, and understand the customer need further. In turn, this helped inform our product roadmap and feature prioritization. Because Liz and Haley had established a collaborative relationship with some of our suppliers, we were able to test the entire user experience end-to-end from requester to reporter. These early adopters partnered with us in migrating to Microsoft Sustainability Manager as a reporting platform.
So that partnership and collaboration across procurement and suppliers and project engineering was pivotal to improving our own data collection and management processes?
Definitely.
And it continues to influence our feature roadmap for Cloud for Sustainability.
Is there anything you could share with us today about that?
We're pretty excited about the new ESG value chain solution in Microsoft Sustainability Manager, which is now in preview. We have streamlined the emissions survey process, and we enable users to really customize the questions that they need to ask their suppliers, which helps provide them the flexibility to add, remove, modify questions as regulations and reporting requirements and methodologies evolve. Additionally, suppliers can easily provide their emissions, activities, product carbon footprint, and emission factor data in real time. We've also enabled self-service features, allowing the procurement team suppliers to easily edit their emissions data, view their customer-specific compliance status, including reasons for non-compliance, and to take action immediately to help resolve any non-compliance to improve the quality of their emissions data.
The inherent flexibility within Sustainability Manager really enables our procurement team to collect supplier emissions data more efficiently and at a more granular level.
And then to add to that, Liz, by leveraging the solution's low-code development, we were able to customize our homepage specific to our program without requiring technical expertise. And while this was simple for our team to maintain and update, it mainly provided a customized and centralized landing page for our suppliers that included quick access to our helpful resources, support, and then an overview of their supplier sustainability requirements. And then we also found that our centralized landing page also reduced supplier inquiries sent directly to our team and instead provided an additional outlet for suppliers to find information and answers to common questions or issues they may have.
Sustainability reporting and progress towards targets is an ongoing process. For instance, many companies are facing mandatory reporting disclosures under the European Union's Corporate Sustainability Reporting Directive, also known as CSRD, which passed in 2023. Are there any new features or functionalities in Sustainability Manager that you're hoping for that relate to the CSRD?
We're all growing the maturity of our sustainability data, including our suppliers. In looking at some of the new ESG regulations and frameworks, including CSRD, we saw an opportunity to align with their standards and require our suppliers to get their data third-party assured. And we ended up adding this requirement into our supplier code of conduct in 2022.
The supplier code of conduct sounds like a very compelling way to continue engaging our suppliers as our sustainability programs evolve. What was the intent of including this particular requirement?
Great question. Our hope was that by requiring data to be assured, the integrity and accuracy of the information we were receiving from suppliers would improve. And it worked. Suppliers are able to directly upload their assurance documentation. And in looking at the data we received this past summer, we noticed that our average supplier footprint had shifted.
And while the procurement team was working on improving data, the Cloud for Sustainability team introduced a connection to Power BI within Microsoft Sustainability Manager. This has allowed Liz and Haley to turn their supplier emissions into visual insights and analytics that refreshes in real time when suppliers make updates to their data.
Being able to collect historical data and lagging indicators of sustainability performance within our value chain sounds really promising. And I recall at the beginning of this conversation, Liz had mentioned, we are also asking our suppliers to join us in meeting a carbon reduction of 55% by 2030. Are there any plans to introduce functionalities that will enable us and our suppliers to evaluate leading indicators as they work towards this target?
Yeah, absolutely. The ability for us to view intelligent insights related to outliers, trends, and correlations in our emissions data is now available in public preview. What If analysis is coming in early 2024, which will allow us to compare current carbon emission trends against the forecasted carbon emissions impacts. And new reporting and goal alignment enhancements will help to collect quantitative emissions, water, and waste data in addition to carbon.
And then just to add, with these new capabilities, customers will have better insight into reduction opportunities across their value chain and suppliers, which in turn can have a big impact for our suppliers on their journey to drive emission reduction.
And on our emissions as well. Laila, since sustainability reporting disclosures vary so much region to region and industry by industry, user feedback, both from procurement teams and their value chain partners, has been so valuable in what we are building for purpose and delivering to market. Laila, are there any opportunities for our customers or suppliers to connect directly with your team?
Yes, I'm so glad you asked. Customer feedback has been a key ingredient to our product roadmap, and we welcome all input. Customers can reach us through the Microsoft Cloud for Sustainability community, where they can get timely answers to questions in the forums section, and also submit and vote for feedback and feature requests in the ideas area.
To those tuning in, thank you for watching. We know that the key to meeting our sustainability goals is contingent on empowering people internally here at Microsoft and within our value chain. And that relies on delivering flexible, scalable technology solutions that enable high quality, actionable data to help drive decisions and strategies. When we started the process of supplier reporting for Scope 3 emissions, we were looking into a black box. But now, with a combination of our own technologies and built-for-purpose tooling from the Cloud for Sustainability, we're equipping our employees with the data management infrastructure they need to efficiently and effectively partner with their suppliers in a scalable way. As we use technology to drive progress, we're committed to listening to and helping our customers and partners reduce their environmental footprint through cloud-based solutions. We can all play a role in creating a more sustainable future. And in case you missed my previous conversation with Erica Basham about Microsoft's internal data collection, I encourage you to check it out. In the meantime, thank you so much to Liz, Haley, and Laila for joining us today and sharing your experiences with us.